So really, brothers, when we see what is happening today, many of the prophecies, of course, are not very pleasant prophecies. That evil will prosper, evil will dominate. But on a different note, this should revive our iman. This is exactly what Nabi alayhi salam said. As Allah said regarding the people of the book, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ إِذَا يُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ The those that were given the book before the Quran, when the Quran was revealed, they fell down and they cried. And they said, ويقولون سبحان ربنا إن كان وعد ربنا لمفعولا. What Allah prophesied in the Quran, what to happen? Yeah, the Quran has come, and yeah, the Prophet Muhammad has made his appearance. Now listen to what Nabi alayhi salam tells the Sahaba. Nabi alayhi salam tells the Sahaba three things: فَقِهُ أَقَاطُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَأَقْرِئُهُ الْقُرْآنَ وَأَطْلِقُ لَهُ أَسِيرَهُ. Do to three things with this person. Number one, teach him about Deen. Number two, make him literate in Quran, and number three, release his son for him. What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? فَقِّهُ أَقَاطُمْ فِي الدِّينِ Take him and teach him. Number two, أَقْرِئُهُ الْقُرْآنِ Teach him Quran. I was reading, there were those Sahaba, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, خُذُ الْقُرْآنَ مِنْ أَرْبَعَ You want to learn Quran, learn it from these four. These are my four reliable people. Allahu Akbar. What a virtue. You know, the other day I was thinking, and Allah put this thought in my mind. Nowadays we have, mashallah, and in all due respect, we have a lot of titles that we afford to senior people. We call them this Sheikh and this Hazrat. And, you know, Hakimul Ummat, Shafiqul Ummat. And maybe the only thing left now is Bazidul Ummat, like someone said. We afford them great, great titles, and rightfully so. Rightfully so. These were great, great people. But one word from Allah regarding His Nabi, which Allah says, نِعْمَ الْعَبْدُ إِنَّهُ أَوَّابٌ نِعْمَ الْعَبْدُ إِنَّهُ أَوَّابٌ You read Surah Saffat and Allah speaks of the Anbiya and Allah says, what a good man Ayyub was. What a good man Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam was. But that ni'mah has done, no titles of the world can ever do. Ni'mah al-abd. This is Allah saying. Allah's praise is free from exaggeration. Whatever Allah says, Allah knows the reality of a person. Allah knows the absolute reality of a person. Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam says, let's teach him deen. Sahaba says, we started teaching him, we released his son. And after teaching him, he became so close to Nabi alayhi salam. And because of his closeness, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu was very strong, apparently harsh, but his heart was so clean. His heart was so clean. What did the Quran say? أَشِدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ أَشِدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ فَرَاهُمْ رُكَّعٍ سُجَّدًا يَبْتَغُونَ فَضْلًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانًا May Allah make this a reality in our life. Somebody comes home and asks maybe, he says, you know what, he might be at the shop, or maybe he'll be there at Computer World, or maybe he'll be at his friend's place. These are one of the three places you'll find him. Allah said, if you want to look for my Sahaba, you'll either find them in Ruku, or in Sajda, or doing something pleasing me. You won't find them anywhere else. فَرَاهُمْ رُكَّعًا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا There's no third place you could find them. Allah make that a reality that we can also find our children in the masajid. On this very night, wherever youngsters are, may Allah bring them home safely. Any youngster sitting in any club, may Allah give him a shiver and bring him home. May Allah let his parents sigh with relief. That youngster dying with any strange woman, may Allah give him a shiver and bring him home. Say Ameen, brothers. We share in the pain of those parents. We cry in the pain of those parents. Nabi alayhi salam said, you want to learn Quran, learn it from four people. Salim Mawla Abi Huzaifa, who was also a free slave of Abu Huzaifa radiallahu anhu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Ubay ibn Ka'ab, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhum. Nabi alayhi salam said, you want to learn Quran from them. In the battle of Yamama, Abu Huzaifa meets Salim. He says, come, let's both give our lives today. So they both sit and they agree. Abu Huzaifa goes around chanting one slogan, Ya Ahl al-Qur'an, Zayyinu al-Qur'an bi'amalikum. Ya Ahl al-Qur'an, Zayyinu al-Qur'an bi'amalikum. For the people of the Qur'an, beautifying this Qur'an with practicality. And Salim Mawla Abu Huzaifa goes around chanting one slogan, Bi'sa hamilu al-Qur'ani ana. Bi'sa hamilu al-Qur'ani ana. They cannot be a more evil hafiz than myself if I don't present my life today. بِئْسَ حَامِلُ الْقُرْآنِ أَنَا. What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? When the Salim Mawla Abi Hudhayfa came, Nabi alayhi wa sallam looked at him and said, Alhamdulillahi alladhi ja'ala min ummati mithlak. All praise belongs to Allah who made you part of my ummah. All praise belongs to Allah who made you part of my ummah. Where father is boasting that I'm so honored that this is my son, and Nabi is boasting that this is my companion. What honor, what a privilege. You want to learn Quran from them. So anyway, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, teach them Quran. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, after Umar accepted Islam, and he became close to Nabi alayhi salam, he used to say, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَقِنْزِيرٌ كَانَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ عُمَرْ حِينَ طَلْعَ عَلَيْنَا وَهُوَ الْيَوْمَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ بَعْضِ وُلْدِي.
Beware of fraudulent copies of this and other media products. Fraudulent copies prevent and destroy the possibility of future productions. Help us to continue providing you with digital media products. Buy a genuine copy.
For all your CD needs, contact Simtek Islamic CDs, 082-500-9111. Simtek Islamic CDs, manufacturers and distributors of Islamic audio and media CDs.
When this man came with the evil intention to kill Nabi alayhi salam, I loved an animal more than him. But I swear by Allah, when he's proven to be a true, genuine Muslim, I love him more than my own blood son. This was the unity that united Sahaba. Their hearts were clean and they were totally united. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, what statement he made? First, one day he was sitting. Look at their condition. Amirul Mu'mineen. So one woman comes in the gathering of Umar radiallahu anhu and he says, إِنَّ زَوْجِي يَقُومُ النَّهَارُ وَيَقُومُ اللَّيْلِ. My husband, for our sisters, maybe they will get happy. My husband, he performed Salah whole night and he fast whole day. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu said, نِعْمَ الرَّجُلُ زَوْجُكُ. MashaAllah, you got a good husband. وَكَانَ فِي مَجْلِسِهِ رَجُلًا يُسَمَّى كَعْبًا. In the gathering, there was one person by the name of Ka'b. He was a very brilliant, talented, skilled person. He said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, inna hadhihi al-mar'a tashku zawjataha. Tashku zawjataha. Amir al-Mu'mineen marked, just to set the record correctly, if I understood the implications of this statement, this woman is complaining about her husband. She's not praising her husband, she's complaining when she said he fasts all day and he makes namaz all night. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu said, if you understood it, then rather you decide in the matter. So anyway, he said, bring the woman and come. So the woman came. The person came. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, simple, humble, clean. If you got the better understanding, it's yours. When Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu was in the throes of death, it comes to mind now. And then he gathered. جَعَلَ الْخِلَافَةَ شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ. And he decided that six people, among them they must decide. At that time he said, if Salim Mawla Abi Hudhayfa was alive, without reservation, I would have made him the governor of the Ummah. لَوْ كَانَ سَالِمٌ حَيَّتْ لَوْ كَانَ سَالِمٌ حَيَّتْ لَوَلَّيْتُهُ الْأَمْرِ. Believe me, you know, we feel that these celebrities are remembered after their death. And people speak about them and their monuments on their name. What an honor in the favor of Salim that Amir al-Mu'mineen Umar ibn al-Khattab at the throes of death said, if that Salim was alive, believe me, without reservation, I would have handed the reins to him. So anyway, this woman comes and Ka'b asks her, what is the matter? So she says that this is the reality, that لَيْلُهُ وَنَهَارُهُ لَا يَرْقُدُهُ لَيْلُهُ وَنَهَارُهُ لَا يَرْقُدُهُ. That in the night and the day he doesn't sleep. فَلَسْتُ فِي أَمْرِ النِّسَاءِ أَحْمَدُهُ. So he might be pious, but you know, as far as conjugal relation is concerned and as far as matrimonial obligations are concerned, I doubt he's a good man. I doubt he's a good man. He might be pious in other things, but in matrimonial relation, فَلَسْتُ فِي أَمْرِ النِّسَاءِ أَحْمَدُهُ. So, Ka'b asked this person, now what's your story? He said, زَهَّدَنِي عَنْ فِرَاشِهَا وَعَنِ الْحُلَلِ. There's something in the Quran, there are certain verses in the Quran that has made me oblivious of the beauty of my wife. I don't doubt she is beautiful, she has the beauty, but there are certain verses of the Quran that I have contemplated over it, And because of that, it has made me oblivious. And then the couplet story is very long. I will take a lot of time if I digress into that. But then Sayyidina, look at this person. And Umar radiallahu anhu is listening. Sahab said, you know what? Whatever you do, your piety and everything is in its place. Allah has given allowance for 4 wives. So that means you have to visit your wife once every fortnight. So whatever you say, every fortnight you have to visit your wife. I do not see any fa'ati haqqaha. Give her right. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu says, I don't know, must I be more astounded with the wisdom of this woman or with your skills in ruling? Idhab faqad wallaytuka al-basra. Go from today, talented people come sit in my gatherings, you are the governor of Basra as long as I'm in charge. You are the governor of Basra. What I'm saying is how united their hearts were, how clean their hearts were. Sayyidina Umar stood up and he found out, when he became the Amir, he said that, what was the meher of Fatima radiallahu anhu? So people said, 400 dirhams. So he said, oh people listen, لا تغالوا في مهور النساء. Don't ever give more than 400 dirhams to women. Fatima radiallahu anhu was given 400 dirhams. So it comes in the riwayat, فهاب المسلمون. People, you know, Umar, the awe strike in Umar, nobody could speak. One woman stood up. And she said, ماذا تقول في قول الله تعالى؟ وآتيتم إحداهن قنطارا فلا تأخذوا منه شيئا. Umar, what you speak? Doesn't the Quran says when husband and wife separate, even if you have given her treasures, don't take it back. So there's such an indication you can give your wife treasures. Umar said, امرأة أصابت ورجل أخطأ. امرأة أصابت. Today we will change history. Woman has said the correct thing and a man has called it. Sahaba Ikram had this unity. They had this close. We were supposed to speak of Quran and unity. We're still touching on the first topic. But anyway, brothers, let us see how we get united. This will strengthen our bond. Umar ibn Wahab sits in the company of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. His companion Safwan is waiting every day. Give me any news. Was Muhammad assassinated? Every time somebody comes, he says, any news? He says, no news. One day a caravan came, they asked any news. He said, yes, what's the news? He said, Umar became a Muslim. لَقَدْ أَسْلَمَ عُمَيْرٌ. We seen people going in as journalists and they came out as believers, wallah. People went as spies and they came out as believers. That is Allah's doing. That is Allah's doing. Nobody arrested them, nobody imposed upon them. They got exposed to Islam. When it will be displayed in its original form, then this is its beauty. Umar then comes to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, إني كنت شديدا على إخفاء نور الله عز وجل شديد الأذى على من كان على دين الله عز وجل وإني أحب أن تأذن لي فأقدم مكة فأدعوهم إلى الله وإلى رسوله وإلى الإسلام لعل الله يهديهم وإلا آذيتهم في دينهم كما كنت أوذي أصحابك في دينهم. Holy of Allah, let me open up my heart and pour it out to you. Listen, I left no stone unturned in persecuting you till I took the step to come and assassinate you. It's time now I reverse my talents. It's time now I channel my abilities in the opposite way. I want you to give me permission, I want to go to Makkah. Very politely, I'm going to invite them towards this beautiful being. Who knows, as Allah guided me, maybe Allah guides them. But if they're not going to be guided, then just as I use my talents against you, I'm going to use it in favor of you. Wallahi, la ada'u makanan jalastu fihi bil kufri illa ajlis fihi bil iman. I swear by Allah, I will leave no land on which I sat as a disbeliever. That this land could testify, Umar the kafir sat on me. But that I'm going to sit there as a believer so that this land can say, Umar as a sahabi of Nabi Sassam sat upon me. We call upon the youth in this gathering. And may Allah take my sentiments to youth across the world. That my brother, one was that time when you walked through a university with a flexing hairstyle and a woman in your arm and with a cigarette in your hand. If you want to do tawbah as an atonement to that wrong, it's time you walk in that gathering. You walk in that hostile environment of that campus with the beautiful appearance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That once upon a time people said if you want to see a rebel, it was him. You walk through that very same thing. You resist the criticism as Umar resisted it. And then you lower your gaze. I swear by Allah, if there's anything that will take my Allah's throne, is that young boy. If there's anything that will shake Allah's throne, it's that young boy. This was the love that they had for the deen of Allah. وَاللَّهِ لَا أَدْعُ مَكَانًا جَلَسْتُ فِيهِ بِالْكُفْرِ إِلَّا أَجْلِسْ فِيهِ بِالْإِيمَانِ Safwan bin Umayyah, he also accepted Islam. I just complete the incident. One day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was walking and he had, you know, a whole herd of sheep with him. So he started looking at it. Nabi alayhi salam said, يُعْجِبُكَ مَا تَرَى? You like what you see? If somebody looks at our being and says, but you like it? He says, yeah. Say, well, that's the closest you get to it. Like it from far. Now there's those cars also. You are too close to me. You are too close to me. And the children play with it, you see. Nabi alayhi salam said, you like it? He says, yes, you can have it. He says, you mean I can have it? Nabi alayhi salam says, yes, take it. He goes back to his people. He says, Wallahi ya qawm aslimu. Oh, Wallahi inna Muhammadan la yu'ti hata'an ma yakhafu al-faqr. Listen, I swear by Allah, this man hasn't come to take your money, he's come to give you money. He hasn't come to take your money, he's come to give you money. Brothers, this is the first thing we need to realize, that this ummah needs to be united. And I have said this often, let me conclude this point on this here. That the reality of our life is we meet seldom. This is the sad reality. But let us become this much that when we meet, we say kind words. Unfortunately, we only meet at weddings and janazas, and we spoil that meeting also with the insulting comments and the snobbish attitude. You lost your way. What happened? Why you ended up here? No. We all are caught up. Each man's own obligations got him so engrossed that he doesn't have time to share in the joy and the pains of others. And we understand our life is this year. It's time we respect it. We don't have to wait for Qiyamah. لِكُلِّ مْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِي. Imagine what Qiyamah will be when we see it in this world. لِكُلِّ مْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِي. Each man will be gripped in a condition which will make him oblivious of his partner. Now Allah speaks of Qiyamah. You see today a man driving the rush, the stench, the tension, the stress upon him. What the poet says, إِنِّي رَأَيْتُكَ جَالِسًا فَعَلِمْتُ أَنَّكَ لِلْهُمُومِ قَرِينُ إِنِّي رَأَيْتُكَ جَالِسًا مُسْتَقْبِلِي فَعَلِمْتُ أَنَّكَ لِلْهُمُومِ قَرِينُ هَوِّنْ عَلَيْكَ وَكُنْ بِرَبِّكَ وَاثِقًا فَأَخُذْ تَوَكُّلِ شَأْنُهُ التَّهْوِينُ صرح الأذى عن نفسه في رزقه لما تيقن أنه مضمون. Oh my brother, when I seen you sitting before me, the very gesture of your famous face showed me that you're in depression. The very gesture of your face indicated depression. سألت من الأطباء خبيرا ذات يوم مما شيبي فقال بلغموا فقلت له على غير احتسام لقد اخطأت فيما قلت بلغموا. You need to understand this in Arabic to appreciate it. Anyway, khair. So, whenever we meet, let us say kind words. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that when the one that was strengthened dies, the barakah of that is Allah will give him barakah in his health also and in his wealth also. Allah will give him barakah in his health and his wealth. I share with you one incident, the Quran speaks very briefly. But today every man, it's a reality that it's human nature. You tell a child, go to the shop, what will you give me? That's human nature. And if you make a reasonable contract with him, he will go. The reality is that today, unfortunately, we have to tempt people to deen also through dunya. It is sad, but it is a reality. I ask that brother, who will be printing Ramadan calendars in the month of Ramadan, are you printing it sincerely to educate the ummah with the correct time, or are you telling me the next time I want to go to a general dealer, I know where to go? Sincerely, I ask you, I'm afraid while Ramadan was a month where the angel said, Ya Baghil Khair Akbil, wa Ya Baghil Shar Aqtil, O seeker of good, seize the opportunity, O seeker of evil, pause for a little while. Even this opportunity we have seized for monetary reasons. We seized it for monetary reasons. Those calendars are not coming in our masjid to tell us the time of salah and the sunnah of fasting. If that was the reason, then minus all the other advertisements. But it is in the masjid and in the house of Allah, we will know the next time I need to go to this supermarket, I know where to find it. Your friendly shopkeeper, your friendly, whatever it is. So anyway, Allah speaks about this incident in the Quran. It's a very long incident about Bani Israel. One person was murdered. and they wanted to know the murderer. I just want to show how Allah will give you barakah when you will be kind and you will strengthen your ties. We need to apply, Allah has given us, you know, they talk of marketing strategies and instituting different measures, and constantly they are upgrading the different billboards, the different advertisements. We as Muslim businessmen, we branch off to a particular category in business, in economics, which the others cannot comprehend, never mind do it, there is barakah. We branch off to that. This boy became a qualified accountant. So he came and started doing his father's books and auditing. He said, "Dad, you're spending too much money, you'll be insolvent very soon." He said, "Hey, listen. Give your degrees for a little while, listen. Tell me what's there more in the world, the sheep, there's more sheep in the world or more dogs? Which one gives birth to more?" "Sheep gives birth to one, dogs give birth to many more." "What we slaughter every year?" "Say sheep." "Is there a shortage of sheep or is there a shortage of dogs?" He said, "No, there's no shortage of sheep." He says, "My friend, that is how Allah's deen works. The more you slaughter for Allah's deen, the more Allah gives you." Did we ever hear that? "No, this year we're not slaughtering sheep. Why there's no sheep?" So now people are leaving cows and coming to sheep also. So anyway, Allah has given us something like barakah. Al-bayyi'ani bil-khiyar. See the ahadith of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. So, Bani Israel came to Musa alayhi salam. وَإِذْ قَتَلْتُمْ نَفْسًا فَادَّارَأْتُمْ فِيهَا وَاللَّهُ مُخْرِجٌ مَّا كُنْتُمْ تَكْتُمُونَ فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam asked Allah, "We want to identify who's the murderer. We want to know who's the murderer. How can we locate it? Today we think we are advanced and we have this intelligence and we can find out who's the father and we have DNA and we have all other things." Allah Ta'ala makes his own intizam and Allah makes his own arrangement. Allah Ta'ala told Musa alayhi salam, "Tell them to slaughter a cow, take a piece of the dead cow and strike it on the dead man and he will stand up and say, 'Who killed me?'" Obviously that was through the miracle of Musa alayhi salam. You try it, not going to work. Anyway, Bani Israel started making a lot of conditions. He said, "Tell us what the color of the cow," then Allah revealed the verse. "Tell us what the age of the cow," then Allah revealed the verse. "Tell us what the nature of the cow," then Allah revealed the verse. So he started making a lot of questions, you know. And accordingly, Allah made things difficult. They started searching for a cow. They find a yellow one, but it's not young. No way, it's not going to help. They find a cow that's yellow, but it's not yellow. And the Quran says, فَاتِعُ اللَّوْنُهَا conspicuous. تَصُرُّ النَّاظِرِينَ, striking to the eye. They start looking. In Tafsiriya, Uthmani, it is written in the Hasya. Finally, they go into one village, desperate to find the cow because they want to locate the murderer. And they have to slaughter a cow that complies with all these requisites because of their nature. They find one young boy living in a little farm. This is in Tafsiriya, Uthmani. One young boy there, and he had the cow precisely to the description. So, he didn't want to sell it because his cow was getting milk and he was living. But they were desperate. He said, "If you are desperate, then you will have to pay, my friend." They said, "We'll pay anything." He said, "You know how much gold can fit in the carcass of the cow? That's the price of this cow." They said, "We'll give it to you." They gave it to him. A man who owned one cow overnight became a cattle farmer. In the tafsir it is written, Allah channeled this barakah to him because he was kind to his mother. Overnight Allah gave him money. Overnight. Allah can give to anyone. They say, Qarun became wealthy because he found one treasure of Yusuf alayhi salam in the Marifur Quran. So what I'm saying is, we don't have to follow the economic step. We don't have to, I'm not saying move out of the jurisdiction, and I'm not saying that, you know, do not apply whatever marketing opportunities you have. But as Muslims, this is the way. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, strengthen your ties. Strengthen your ties. Be kind. Be loyal. Be faithful to your parents, to your relatives. That is the only thing that will bring barakah in your life, and that will give you barakah in your wealth. I just mentioned few things with regard to Quran, and I will conclude. Coming back to my opening comment, that the solution of the Sunnah is that we latch onto the Quran and we unite. And if every person in his own way will endeavor to bring unity in his own house, a father within his children, what message do we advocate to our children? I mean, how often we tell the children, you don't ever eat by your fork and don't ask why. You don't ask questions. You don't. Whenever you go there, you must say Jazakallah. So the child grows up hating his fork for reasons he knows not. Then the child grows up loving his daddy for the sake of his father and hating her for the sake of his mother. So this is a reality of our life. This is a sad reality of our life. So what unity are we echoing? You know, we tell our children, I want you to be together, I want muhabbat. But what are they seeing between us? And study, brothers, one of the greatest things that has divided our family network is money. One of the contributing factors to breaking up our marriage is somewhere when money exchanged the hands. Then it became sour, it became ugly, and then, they broke up. So let us on our own scale try our level best to back up. Let us learn to say kind words. The condition of a believer is such that he should, have good thoughts about people. Look at this here what the Quran says. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٌ وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا. One day Mawlana Ibrahim Jawahir Sahib was giving a talk to certain ulama, and I had the opportunity to be present there, and he mentioned something very unique. He said, Allah has made the sin forbidden in the sequence in which the sin gains momentum. The first thing that happens is you entertain a negative thought about someone. Now, the command is that you should clear your mind of that thought. But on the contrary, you go and investigate it. So you go and probe the whole thing. And when you find him to be guilty of the wrong, you rejoice that your conclusions were correct. That look, when I said he was up to something, I was right. And then what is it after that? وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا. Then you can't sit with that son, now you promote it to the world. So the Quran says, don't entertain thoughts. Don't entertain thoughts. Abu Ayyub Ansari was at home for our sisters. You know, we sometimes use, I always say, Allah has given women unique talent to convert. You come home, the wife says, you're going shopping, you say, no, you're mad. And 20 minutes time, you're in the car going to the shop. How that happens and when it happens, I don't know, you don't know, but it's a reality. I'm tired, I'm not going, and in 20 minutes time, you're in that car with your tired and your pulled up face, but you're going. If only my sister can use her channel and channel her husband in the right way, like the wife of Amr ibn Jamu told him, that I don't think you are excused because of your lame foot. I think you don't want to be martyred. Allahu Akbar. His wife is telling him this. I don't think you are excused, but as the Quran says, ليس على الأعمى حرج ولا على الأعرج حرج ولا على المريض حرج. ليس على الأعمى حرج ولا على الأعرج حرج ولا على المريض حرج. They are excused. The only verse that was revealed, the shortest verse revealed independently in the Quran was غير أولي الضرر. لا يستوي القاعدون من المؤمنين غير أولي الضرر. The shortest independent verse. Jibreel came down exclusively just for that. So the sick people are excused. He performed salah. He says, this is the comments of my wife. Allahumma la turuddani ila ahli. My wife, I make salam, and I make salam to the people of this house. I'm leaving never to return. I'm leaving never to return. So if a woman can use her talent and channel it in the right way, and carry her husband in the right way, Abu Ayyub Ansari radiallahu anhu comes home, his wife says, you heard what Aisha did. Now, woman, amru heliyehu kido. Heliyehu kido. So who kido? Then, after the whole thing, and when you're about to take what, don't quote me, I just heard, Malinikava, I'm not too sure. Why you told me, my sister? Why you spoiled my akhirat and your akhirat? Wallah, we got enough to jeopardize it, we don't need to cloud the issue more. Wallah, we are in a crisis, we don't need to. I always say this in my lectures, that if it wasn't a sin for me to tell you my sins, believe me, I would have told you, but the hadith says, if I tell you my sins, I'm committing another sin, and I don't need to do that. Allah be my witness. Whenever people make their fancy praises, often I'm tempted to tell the man my wrong, but then I'll be committing another sin. The hadith of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, Kullu ummati mu'afan illa al-mujahideen. Allah will forgive all those, but Allah will forgive every sinner, but the one who sins openly. And among those that are guilty of sinning openly are the men who sin secretly. وَقَدْ بَعْضَ يَسْتُرُهُ رَبُّهُ. And Allah out of His kindness veils your wrong. And in the morning you get up and you say, I enjoyed this woman and this wine. Allah says, you did the wrong against me. I veiled you. And you have the audacity to go and tell others, I will never forgive you. So believe me, if it wasn't a sin for me to tell you, I would have told you. I give the example, it's simple, brothers. Somebody comes and prays you. You know, I give it in the following way. This is how evil of us. Person comes and tells you, one day you're a fool, he tells you you're a monkey, he gives you some dirty titles. You tell him, why? By you saying it doesn't change the reality. Doesn't make me that. Then the next week, mashallah, Friday, he sees you with a kurta dress. He says, mashallah, you look like a mufti. Make dua, it's all from Allah. What from Allah? My lies are from Allah? Last week when I called you an age, then it didn't change reality. But when you're looking like an angel because it suits you well, so make dua, it's all from Allah. What from Allah? You tell me, my brother, it's time we come out of these phrases, wallah. We have to mature this. How can we get fletched when we know our wrong? تمر ساعات أيامي بلا ندم ولا خوف ولا بكاء ولا حزن تمر ساعات أيامي بلا ندم ولا بكاء ولا خوف ولا حزن أنا الذي يغلق الأبواب مجتهدا على المعاصي وعين الله تنظرني يا زلة كتبت في غفلة ذهبت يا حسرة بقيت في القلب تحرقني دعني أنوح على نفسي وأندبها وأقطع الدهر بالتفكير والحزن ولقد أتوا بالطبيب كي يعالجني ولم أرى اليوم الطبيب ينفعني سيخرج الروح مني في تغرغرها وصار ريقي مرا حين غرغرها واشتد نزعي وصار الموت يجذبني من كل عرق بلا رفق ولا هوني وصلوا صلاة لا ركوع لها ولا سجود لعل الله يرحمني وألبسوني ثيابا لا كمام لها وألبسوني ثيابا لا كمام لها وصلوا صلاة لا ركوع لها ولا سجود لعل الله يرحمني. Brothers, if you reflect over this year, you will never be flattered by the praise of any man. You will never be flattered by the praise of any man. The poet brings my picture, your picture in these couplets. What is our condition? I'm the one who shuts the door and disobeys Allah. The days of my weeks, the weeks of my months, the months of my years are just going by without my Allah. The days to come when my children will gather around me and some will be saying, gone Warana, others one will be saying, call the doctor. And I know in the heart of hearts, gone are the days where doctors can assist me. Very soon my soul will leave. The first thing that will happen, my saliva will become bitter. And then they will put clothes on me with no sleeves. And they will perform a namaz with no ruku and sajda. And they will drop me hoping that my Allah saves me. وَأَلْبَسُونِ ثِيَابًا لَا كِمَامَ لَهَا وَصَلُّوا صَلَاةً لَا رُكُوعَ لَهَا وَلَا سُجُودَ لَعَلَّ اللَّهَ يَرْحَمُنِي. So what I'm saying is, we don't need to do things to jeopardize our. We need to realize our reality. Let us not be flattered by any man. I know my son, my brother, you know your son. Our wives cannot respect us as others do simply because they know a portion more of us which others don't know. And there's that other portion which even they don't know, only Allah knows. And we beg Him, He never reveals it to anyone. We beg Him, He never reveals it. Believe me, if you only had to know what my heart harbors and what my heart has, then you wouldn't have taken the trouble to come here and listen. I know my condition, you know your condition, my brother. So we need to do things that will bring us closer to Allah. Why commit these gunas that earn us no pleasure and yet jeopardize our akhirat? Jeopardize our akhirat. Abu Ayyub Ansari comes home, his wife says, you heard what Aisha did. What did Abu Ayyub Ansari, and that is the advice I leave every man with. Now this was a slander and accusation against Aisha regarding zina. He tells his wife, tell me, will you commit zina? She says, no. He says, you my wife and you won't commit it. Aisha being the wife of Muhammad, will she commit it? I refute what you say. I need not investigate it. That's a blatant lie. And hence the Quran praises him. لَوْلَا إِذَ سَمِعْتُمُوهُ ظَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بِأَنفُسِهِمْ خَيْرًا لَوْلَا إِذَ سَمِعْتُمُوهُ ظَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بِأَنفُسِهِمْ خَيْرًا وَقَالُوا هَذَا إِفْكٌ مُبِينٌ. As believers, when you hear these accusations, you ought to refute it. Let us say things that will unite hearts, not break up hearts. And as men, let us not entertain these things. Let us put an end to it. Your wife brings that home, your child brings that home, let's not get involved in it. Look at Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu. One day he's talking something to Nabi alayhi salam. Then he comes home, so he tells his mother, what were you talking? So he tells his mother, no, it was a secret. Hadith comes in all the books, authentic books of hadith. It was a secret. Now, if our son tells us that, then we know what we say. Our anger. Now, what secret has he got against? What did the mother say? My son, it's a secret. You may say, but don't tell it to anyone. Secret, you must never divulge. Don't even tell me. Now, that is what we're supposed to echo to our children. The child comes home, the mother asks the child, what are you talking? He says, it's a secret. Mother says, a secret is something you keep to yourself. Don't even tell me. That is the teachings we need to promote. That is how we need to unite the Ummah. One day, Khalid ibn Walid and Abdurrahman ibn Awf had an argument that revived comes in Hayat al-Sahaba. So Khalid radiallahu anhu came to Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. Abdurrahman ibn Awf came to Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam and he told Nabi salatu wa salam, oh Nabi Allah, Khalid, he is always interfering with me. Nabi alayhi salam said, Khalid, Abdurrahman is a Badri. He participated in Badr. The Quran speaks about Badr. وَإِذْ غَدَوْتَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ تُبَوِّئُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ مَقَاعِدَ لِلْقِتَالِ وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. You have to understand that in the eloquence of the Quran is the Quran paints it. وَإِذْ غَدَوْتَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ تُبَوِّئُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ مَقَاعِدَ لِلْقِتَالِ وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Oh Khalid, don't interfere with Abdul Rahman, he's a Badri. So Khalid said, oh Nabi of Allah, I respect what you said, but you don't realize Abdul Rahman starts with me always. The right comes in Hayat al-Sahaba. Now we in this common condition, you know, children are fighting. Nabi alayhi salam said, Abdul Rahman, don't interfere with Khalid. Allah has called Khalid Sayfullah. Nabi alayhi salam wiggled his way out of the argument by making each party familiar with the virtue of the other. Recognize him. Nabi alayhi salam said, Abdul Rahman, don't interfere with Khalid. He's the only one who's got the title of being Sayfullah. Now, let us learn to understand this here. Nabi alayhi salam never forgot the participation of Badr even afterwards. When Hatib ibn Abi Balta, Allah speaks about it, Surah Mumtahina, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la tattakhidhu aduwi wa aduwakum awliya'a tulquna ilayhim bil mawadda. When the Prophet ﷺ was about to invade Makkah, because he had some relatives, he became emotional, so he divulged the plan of Nabi alayhi salam. And through divine revelation, he was informed that Hatib has divulged your secret, which is going to be a setback to your invasion. So Nabi alayhi salam sent to Sahaba, Ali radiallahu anhu, Nizar ibn Aswad, he said, gallop your horses, hatta ta'atu rawza taqa. You come to this location, there's a woman, she's got valuable information, intercept her in the note and bring it back. Nabi alayhi salam, these two Sahaba went, they galloped their horses, they got there, they intercepted her, brought her, sat down in front of Nabi alayhi salam. Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a walked in front. Said, Nahumma said, da'ani adrib unaka hadha al-munafiq. Nabi Allah, why discuss the matter? Let me finish him here. Nabi alayhi salam said, waqad shahida badran. Waqad shahida badran. Umar, what's your word? He was part of Badris. Umar, what's your word? He was part of those of... I can't overlook the fact that he participated in Badr. So it is important we learn the methodology of Nabi alayhi salam. Last week I was speaking at one function. Now I'm really asking for mass. And I'm ending, inshallah. I was speaking at one function and I was speaking, addressing some teachers. First, today, you know, we have this therapy and we have this methodology and we have this classes and we have different approach, you know, to enhance the education of our children. It's very important. But we are undermining the methodology of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Nabi alayhi salam dealt with the most rebellious of people. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had people who came out and said, Ya Muhammad, ukhruj. Muhammad, when you come out, Muhammad, I want to talk to you. People who came and said that. Muhammad, I'm looking for Muhammad. Allah reveals the Quran. Inna alladhina yunadunaka min wara'i. You know, we say we've got children, hey, he's a terror. And he runs up. You know? When I remember when we were small and the child was disobedient, then you hit him one, two, and then you straighten him up. Now if he gives you a problem, medical connotation. ADD. Attention deficit disorder. So now there's somebody else, you take him for therapy, he pays, you pay him more time, and I don't know if you help in the situation. So there's constant diagnosis. You know, this here, you're breaking this into, you're fragmenting this in here. There's another critical analogy here. There's some other division to this here. Only this. But study the methodology of Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. How did, wallah, when I read this here, I cry because I know I'm way off the mark. I'm way off the mark. What did that sahabi say? I walked into the masjid and then I sneezed. So I said, Alhamdulillah. So people started looking at me. So I said, Masha'anukum tanduruna ilayya. Now this was after Allah made speech forbidden in namaz, but I didn't know the ruling. I said, what's wrong, you people are looking at me? So they said, keep quiet. So I kept quiet. After Namaz, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called me. فوالله ما كفرني ولا ضربني ولا شتمني فما رأيت معلما قبله ولا بعده أحسن منه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called me. He didn't disgrace me. He didn't victimize me. He didn't ridicule me. He didn't marginalize me. He said, listen, Allah has made speech equivalent in salah. I swear by Allah, neither has the skies nor the earth seen a more noble future than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The riwayat in Abu Dawud, one person joined the salah. Nabi alayhi wa sallam went into ruku. So to secure the rakat, he makes Allah over at the door. And then he starts walking in ruku. Now if it was us, you should have started namaz at home, brother. If you're starting at the door and walking in namaz, you start namaz at home and come in. But who was my Nabi? Who was my Nabi? He said, زَادَكَ اللَّهُ حِرْصًا وَلَا تَعُودُ. I cried when I read this. زَادَكَ اللَّهُ حِرْصًا وَلَا تَعُودُ. Listen, I salute your aspiration. I salute your endeavor, but the action is not right. Your zeal is noble to secure a rakat. There's nothing better. That may Allah increase you in your zeal for what you did. So don't repeat this action. So we need to look into measures to unite this ummah. And the Quran is the way through which we unite this ummah. By virtue of the Quran, Nabi alayhi salam sent the sahaba the riwayat in Bukhari. I mentioned this often. And the sahaba used to recite Surah Ikhlas in every rak'ah. We did it for convenience sake. Just look at the difference in intention. We did it the very same thing we do, it deprives us. The same thing it did, a sahabi did, and see what he earned through that. Why we did Surah Ikhlas? We think Allah revealed it so we got something in Nafil Namaz. Nabi Ali, when the Sahaba returned, they asked Nabi Ali, some one of you of Allah, you know, Alhamdulillah, we had a very good time. Our Amir had very peculiar practice. He used to read Surah Ikhlas in every rakah. Surah Fatiha and Surah Ikhlas. So again, Nabi Ali teaches us lessons. Nabi Ali said, he did it, ask him. Why are you asking me? Now, we go to the Mawlana, you've seen how that brother was reading Namaz. He was reading, ask him, why must the Mawlana do that? These are the things that unfortunately has crept into our ummah and has divided us. Has divided us, has caused so much bickering among us. Nabi alayhi salam said, ask him. So they asked him, he said, لِأَنَّهَا صِفَةُ الرَّحْمَانِ. Because Surah Ikhlas describes my Allah and I love my Allah. The riwayat of Tirmidhi, Nabi sallallahu alayhi said, حُبُّكَ إِيَّاهَا أَدْخَلَكَ الْجَنَّةِ. Your passion for Surah Ikhlas, I promise, is enough for your entry into Jannah. Your passion for one, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ أُنْزِلَ أَشْرَفُ الْكُتُبِ بِأَشْرَفِ اللُّغَاتِ عَلَى أَشْرَفِ الرُّسُلِ بِسِفَارَةِ أَشْرَفِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ فِي أَشْرَفِ شُهُورِ السَّنَةِ فَكَمُلَ مِنْ كُلِّ الْوُجُوهِ. Ibn Kathir says, أُنْزِلَ أَشْرَفُ الْكُتُبِ, the noblest of books, بِأَشْرَفِ اللُّغَاتِ, the noblest of languages, عَلَى أَشْرَفِ الرُّسُلِ, on the noblest of prophets, بِسِفَارَةِ أَشْرَفِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, through the medium of the noblest of angels, and revelation commenced in the noblest of months. Hence, one is compelled to say it has been perfected on every angle. The Quran has been perfected on every angle. Let us make the Quran a reality in our house. Let us learn the Quran. Let us study the Quran. Let us give due respect to the Quran. You see, one of the reasons why the kuffar was deprived, ما يأتيهم من ذكر من ربهم محدة إلا استمعوه وهم يلعبون. لَهِيَةً قُلُوبُهُمْ. While Quran was being revealed, they were talking, they were entertaining many other gatherings. As a result of that, they were deprived of the Quran. Let us give the Quran the due respect. When we sit with the Quran, Usayd ibn Hudayr radiallahu anhu says, if I can remain like how I remain in the gathering when I listen to Quran, I can assure my own entry into Jannah. لَوْ أَنِّي أَكُونُ كما أكون في حال من أحوال الصلاة لكنت من أهل الجنة وما شككت في ذلك. Usayd ibn Hudayr, he is the famous hadith with the horse when the Quran was being recited. He says, if I can live my life like how I sit when the Quran is being released, the due respect. Let us take our time and listen to the Quran recitation of our children. There's much more that could be said, but in conclusion, I make dua to Almighty Allah that firstly He inspires myself, all the brothers and the sisters that have come here. May Allah reward you for your patience, that you have sit and listened to the humble talk that have been said here. The speaker needs to practice on it more than the listeners. Allah Ta'ala take this ummah from strength to strength, unite this ummah, and once again restore the glory of this ummah. Wa akhiru da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.